Dr. Joe Dispenza é autor best-seller do New York Times, pesquisador, conferencista e consultor corporativo. Ele realiza uma brilhante interface entre ciência e espiritualidade, integrando com maestria os conhecimentos da física quântica, neurociência e epigenética, para explorar a ciência por trás das remissões espontâneas. Ele usa esse conhecimento para ensinar as pessoas a curar seus corpos de problemas de saúde, fazer mudanças significativas em suas vidas e desenvolver sua consciência. Desde 2010, ele está com uma equipe de cientistas para pesquisar os efeitos da meditação no coração e nas funções cerebrais, na resposta imunológica e na saúde geral da mente e do corpo. Dr. Joe, é um imenso prazer apresentar o seu trabalho para o público brasileiro, especialmente aos meus seguidores, que já viram falar de você muitas vezes. Portanto, quero deixar aqui a minha imensa gratidão de ter você conosco, poder apresentar esse seu trabalho para o público brasileiro. Nós possamos tocar mentes e corações de pessoas no Brasil e no mundo.
Ah, it's a pleasure to be with you, Wallace.
Nice. Let's go to the first question. No seu livro Quebrando o Hábito de Ser Você Mesmo, você fala como a personalidade é criada e como vivemos comumente no passado, revivendo as experiências emocionais que nos proporcionaram qualquer tipo de ameaça à nossa sobrevivência. Gostaria que você falasse como a nossa personalidade é criada e como podemos reeducar o nosso corpo-mente e transformar uma personalidade doentia e pessimista numa personalidade saudável e otimista.
Ah, a great question, Wallace. Well, one of the foundational principles of the work that we teach, independent of your belief system, whether you're into spirituality, whether you're into psychology, whether you're into being an entrepreneur, the principle is the same, and that is that your personality has a direct effect on your personal reality. And your personality is made up of how you think, how you act, and how you feel. So the present personality who's listening to this presentation has created the present personal reality called their life, which means if you wanted to change your life, if you wanted to change your personal reality, you're going to have to change. You're going to have to change your personality. So there's an economy of action in our biology that says that if you keep thinking the same way, doing the same things, react emotionally the same way, the body tends to economize how we store information. So if we think 60 to 70,000 thoughts in one day, and 90% of those thoughts are the same thoughts as the day before, and you believe that your thoughts have something to do with your destiny, as long as you're thinking in the same way, it makes sense that your life is going to stay the same. So then the same thoughts always lead to the same choices. The same choices always lead to the same behaviors. The same behaviors create the same experiences, and the same experiences produce the same emotions, and those same emotions begin to influence our very same thoughts. Now, the catch is that our biology, our neurocircuitry, our neurochemistry, our hormones, and even our gene expression is equal to how we think, how we act, and how we feel. So the principle of economy says that nerve cells that fire together will wire together. So by thinking the same way, making the same choices, performing the same behaviors, creating the same experiences that lead to the same emotions that reaffirm the feeling that's familiar to you, and you do that 5 to 10 years ongoing, you begin to hardwire your brain into a very finite signature. Now, that finite signature is a level of mind, because mind is the brain in action. So then we're reminding ourselves who we are based on how we think, how we act, and how we feel. You do that enough times, then it all of a sudden becomes like a computer program. And our personality, by the time we're 35 years old, becomes a set of memorized behaviors, automatic habits, unconscious emotional reactions, hardwired beliefs, perceptions, attitudes that function just like a computer program, which means you press start and it runs automatically. So most people's behaviors, most people's thoughts, most people's emotional reactions, they've done so many times that they no longer are conscious that they're doing them. So 95% of who we are by the time we're 35 years old is a set of unconscious states of mind and body. So then crisis, trauma, disease, diagnosis, loss causes a person to finally stop the programs and ask themselves an important question. Do I want to stay this way or do I want to change? Now, the moment we're feeling so unhappy that we're no longer returning our emails or posting on Facebook or Instagram, we're no longer texting back to people, we're no longer showing up for dinner and seeing the same people and doing the same things. When we reach that point in our life where we no longer feel the same way and nothing in our life is making that feeling go away, this is that moment of awakening where the person starts to look and observe and think about what they're thinking about. They start becoming aware and conscious of how they act, how they speak. They notice that the feeling that they've been living by for the last 25 years is guilt, but they didn't know it was guilt because it feels like how they always feel. Now, the moment they can observe those states of mind and body and they become conscious of it, they're no longer unconscious, which means they're no longer in the program. Their consciousness observing their unconscious self, and that's the first step to change. In fact, the word meditation means to become familiar with. So as you become familiar with those hardwired thoughts, automatic habituations, reflexive emotional reactions, when you become so conscious of those unconscious states of mind and body, that you won't go unconscious to your old personality self in your waking day. Now you're out of the bleachers and you're on the playing field. Now the game has begun. So then most people try to change their personality with the 5% of their conscious mind that's working against 95% of what they've programmed subconsciously. And meditation is a way that we use to begin to regulate brainwaves, teach people a formula on how to slow down their conscious mind, open the door between the conscious mind and the subconscious mind, get beyond the analytical mind, and then rewrite the program to change some subconscious state of mind and body so that now they're no longer unconsciously sabotaging themselves and their lives.